peaceful morning in the English countryside. Back from another extended tour of the continent, one of Britain's best known and most popular rock groups. They've been traveling for weeks and they're tired. But on their first day off for months, they've risen at dawn and are on the road again. Recently, they've become addicts, addicted to a pastime which began in America, but which is rapidly becoming popular throughout the rest of the world. Once anyone tastes the thrills of this sport, it seems they're hooked forever. Status quo. Their new all-consuming hobby, off-roading.
Yeah.
Ken Coughlin, drums and percussion. Richard Parfitt, vocalist and rhythm guitar. Francis Rossi, vocals and lead guitar. Alan Lancaster, vocals and bass guitar. Together these four form the world-famous rock band Status Quo. Always perfectionists, they've come here to practice. To practice off-roading. Their instructor, expert Alvin Smith.
Very, very slippery, off the throttle. Allowing the engine to hold you back.
Yeah, that's to stop us sliding, right?
Yeah, right. Let the engine hold you back.
Okay. We're in high range as well,
aren't we? We're in high range, yeah. Plenty of traction here on the grass. Gotta watch these trees here because if they whack a windscreen, you can get a broken windscreen very quickly.
Yeah.
Mainly use the lower gears off-road, so as you take your foot off the throttle, it will slow you down quickly because you haven't always got time to hit the brake, and when you do, very often it'll slide on. There's an adverse camber here to the left, so we'll go down into bottom. Quite a tilt on here.
Yeah. We're using diff lock?
Yes, we're diff lock always off-road. Ground quite rough here. You've got to hold on to the steering and keep your thumbs out of the spokes of the wheel, because as you hit the bumps it will come round.
Oh, now it should be good.
Right, we've got water up ahead, into first and accelerate through it.
Good.
And accelerate away, except the engine's got wet and it's going to cut out.
Oh, good. Oh, good one.
So up with the bonnet.
Never
Can you
was.
Release the bonnet? All the time reading the ground about 15 yards ahead of you. Watch out for any tree stumps and that, but this sort of ground can be
bottles as well.
Yeah. All sorts of stuff. If you're in doubt at all, down in first and just watch the grain, certainly within the first 10 yards ahead of you. Through this opening here. Through the trees. Watch out for thick branches breaking the windscreen. But we've got an incline over here. It's very slippery.
It should be interesting.
Yeah, into bottom. Get the vehicle rolling well. Okay,
there we see. That's a.
We just made that one.
That's a nasty one, actually.
We've got the traction back by coming off the throttle. Okay, Rick, well, the only way you're going to find out how to do it is get in here and have a go.
Right.
Meanwhile, back at the farm, John Coughlin, the group's most devoted and experienced driver, has landed himself in a heap of trouble. It seems that whilst off-roading, much of the time is spent getting covered in mud. Definitely a hobby for those who enjoy a dirty weekend. That is, a weekend of winching, not wenching. John is the only one of the group who has actually raced, but Alvin is putting Richard, who isn't far behind, through the final paces, before he too enters an event.
Okay, Richard, got the diff locked. Right, let's see what you can do. Mind that river. Mind the adverse camber there. First gear. Back her up, yeah.
I'm nearly in this river as it happens.
Right. Okay, now take her forward. Great, off you go again. Watch that slide off the river. That's better.
That's much better. Get ready for that water. First gear. Then accelerate through it. That's the way. Give it a stick. That's the idea. Go on.
Whilst it's always fun, it's not always as easy as it looks. It could use an extra horsepower. Any type of car can enter, but experience has shown that four-wheel drive vehicles are the more frequent survivors. Off-roading will almost certainly break the family saloon, but shouldn't break the bank. This is one of the cheapest of all the motorsports. It's a sort of motorcycle scrambling on four wheels, a test of both the man and the machine, usually against the clock. However, if you spend your Sundays washing and polishing your car, then forget it. There's no future in it for you if you're going to worry about scratch paintwork, lots of mud, collapsed suspension, or the odd bent wing or two. Off-roading is a cult, and off-roaders seem to have only one topic of conversation.
He doesn't know anything about them.
You didn't get over it,
though.
Yeah,
very true.
He'd stirred them up at that time.
It's all good fun, long as you don't break your motor.
I started off roading about a year ago and I joined the club with a Land Rover.
At first I just really used it for puttering about, getting from A to B, and eventually I started kind of adding things to it. You know, I saw another one with a cow bar on the front, so I thought that'd be good. So I got one of them and eventually put wheels on, and then I started going to some... didn't have any wheels on it.
Got into Range Rovers because John bought one to tour with and to generally get around with, and I thought they were good to look at, and I never quite got off them until I actually drove one. And when you drive one for a bit, they're a habit forming thing. You can't get out of the thing, and if you can go on a road, off a road, up the side of a tree, anywhere, that's my scene, man. Who said that? I
don't know. It quite frightened me to compete because I went round with John and it's very hairy, you know. Break your wrists and things like that. Literally, you can. Yeah, I'll have a go. Yeah, I tried it twice, three times, four times.
I do it much as I can when the band's not working. And so it's good fun because when you've been having a hard tour, it's a nice release, you know, back from the playing and sweating and everything. So I'll get back into this and just get just as scared.
Yeah. The night before an event is the last chance to make the vital checks that can make the difference between finishing or not. It's not a dangerous sport, but the safer the vehicle, the safer the driver.
This afternoon it was really pulling to the left when I was braking. I think you'll find some oil down there, Alvin, actually. It's a bit bad.
Yep, you're right, there is. Must be a seal leaking.
Is that bad?
Well, it would be on the public road, but off-road you'll be okay.
Yeah. Well, I'll take it down the trailer tomorrow anyway. I'll
yeah, that's
it
true.
Down.
Yeah, yeah.
There's going to be no problems there. Yeah, so we'll just get by for tomorrow, eh? And just...
That's right. One of these are going to be a
No.
Could you just give a pump up?
Yeah, sure.
Okay,
lovely.
Okay.
Serenaded by a blackbird that thinks the lights from the garage herald the dawn, John and Alvin complete their final checks. Tomorrow, the competition. Win or lose, John will be happy. For Status Quo and all the other off-road fanatics, it's the thrill of the drive that counts.